Hi children, welcome to English class. This is Sri Lakshmi, your 6th grade English teacher. Children, I would like to ask one question. What do you do, children, when you feel bored or when you are free? Either you paint or play. Isn't it, children? Am I right? Okay, good children. Today in our English class, we are going to learn an interesting lesson about a painter. And the name of the story is Meeting Susan. And the story was written by Sir Michael Morpurgo. Children, before we go into the story, let us know about the author. Sir Michael Morpurgo was an English author, poet and playwright. He is best known for his novels and stories for children. Between the years 2003 and 2005, he was named as Children's Laureate of United Kingdom. He won several awards for his work. Children, have you ever heard of Cézanne? Now I am going to show you the picture of Paul Cézanne. Here it is. This is the picture of Cézanne, children. And he was born on January 19, 1839 in France. He entered law school, but he did not like it. He studied law and art at the same time. Cézanne wanted to be an artist, but his parents did not approve his idea. He became an impressionist. He invented a new way of painting called cubism, but he was not confident of his work. Children, Cézanne's paintings were very simple. Nearly for 40 years he painted, and during his 40 years of painting, he created more than 900 oil paintings and 400 watercolors. And most of his paintings were created based upon his observation. Children, have you seen his paintings? Ma, Cézanne's paintings? Now I'm going to show you Cézanne's painting, some of his paintings. Let's have a look. These are his paintings, ma. I think, children, everyone understood about Cézanne, isn't it? Okay, now we'll move into the story. Now I'm going to give the introduction of the lesson followed by the summary. The story is very touching because the speaker is a child protagonist narrating from his point of view. The title is justified because it preserves the suspense that is built around the artist. The theme is that a person is great because of what he is as a person and not because of the name he has made of himself. Let's see summary. And this story is about a young boy named Yannick. And he gets a chance to go and spend time with his uncle's family. Yannick soon begins to enjoy his stay with his uncle's family, helping his uncle run the village inn. Children, do you know what is the meaning of inn? It means a house which provides accommodation and food, especially for travelers. It's called an inn. One day there was a noise in the inn. His cousin Amandine mentioned to Yannick about a famous man who was going to visit the inn and he had to be treated well. Yannick knows only the client to be entertained that evening. But he does not know the identity of the person. However, he was happy. The man was pleased with the dessert he had made. After the man and the guest left, Yannick had crushed and thrown into the fire the tablecloth used for special clients without realizing that it had a sketch from the customer, a famous artist, who drew on the tablecloth as a tip if he liked the food. Amandine shouted at Yannick for throwing the tablecloth into the fire. Meanwhile, Uncle Bruno came in to see what happened. He told Amandine that Yannick did not know he was wrong in tossing the tablecloth into the fire. She had not told him about the artist's way of sketching on the tablecloth to show his approval of their service. Amandine accepted her mistake and apologized to Yannick. Yannick wanted to make amends for upsetting his cousin Amandine, and so he decided to meet the famous painter whose sketch he had thrown into the fire. He wanted to get a new painting from him and gift it to Amandine. The next morning, he traveled through the village and thick forest and finally met the old man who had come to the inn. He explained the purpose of his visit. The old man readily agreed to his request and painted sailing boats for Yannick and signed it as Picasso. Picasso, children, do you know who is Picasso? Picasso is also one of the greatest painters of 20th century. He's a Spanish painter, ma. Cezanne was a French painter and Picasso was a Spanish painter. For whom did Yannick come? Yannick came to meet Cezanne. For what? To get a beautiful painting for Amandine. Why he wanted to give it to Amandine? He wanted to see Amandine very happy. So he wanted to meet Cezanne. Yannick wanted to meet Cezanne and request him to draw a beautiful painting for his cousin. But whom did he meet? He met Picasso. But did Yannick know that before? No. He thought the old man, the artist, was Mr. Cezanne, and he asked him to draw the painting. Why did Picasso didn't reveal that he was not Cezanne? Because he doesn't want to upset the child. He doesn't want to make the child sad. So he didn't reveal the truth. When Yannick came to know about that, after the painting was done, at last he signed as Picasso. By looking at the sign, the signature, Yannick knew that he was not Cezanne, he was Picasso. And he was surprised, Yannick was surprised to see that, because up till that time he thought that he was Cezanne, the famous painter. But who was he? Who drew the beautiful painting for Yannick? Picasso drew the painting for Yannick. From the story, it also shows Picasso's humility and sense of self-worth is not being upset with the child's interacting with him if he was Cezanne. Children, now let's see the learning outcomes of the lesson. Learning outcomes of the lesson are: we should appreciate the innocence of the child, examine the goodness in each of the characters. We can identify the artist as a great man. Also, we can note the talent of a great artist. Children, what did we learn from the lesson? Is the title justified, children? Yeah, the title is justified. The title is Meeting Cezanne. Actually, the boy came to meet Cezanne. Why did Yannick come to meet him, Cezanne? Because he wanted to get a beautiful painting from Cezanne and present it to his cousin Amandine and make her happy. In that process, whom did he meet? Yannick met Picasso and got a beautiful painting from Picasso. Unknowingly, he took the painting from Picasso. Actually, he thought that the person was Cezanne and he requested him to draw beautiful painting. At last, at the end of the lesson, Yannick knew that the person, the old man, was not Cezanne, he was Picasso. And Picasso is also one of the greatest artist children. Hope you all understood, children. Thank you.